While editing, I realized that Boots is barking could be heard a lot, and I'm just gonna let you know in advance. I'm warning you. I'm sorry. I'm not able to edit that out in any way. All I know is I'm never letting Boots outside again while recording. Actually, it wasn't Boots that was outside. I'm never letting Ash outside because Boots wants Ash inside at all times. So, yeah, I'm probably gonna end up hating this video now because, yeah. Just wanted to let you guys know in advance if you hear a bunch of barking because it's gonna go on the entire video. I'm super mad about this right now. What's up, guys? My name is Elien, and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker HD. In the last episode, we completed the Tower of the Gods, and in this episode, we're gonna fight Gohdan, the boss of the Tower of the Gods. And yeah, let's go straight in. Now, you're gonna wanna have your picto box out because we're gonna need to take a picture of him, because he's the only one of his kind, so this is our only chance to, you know, take a picture. And that's one thing I hate about this side quest. Whenever, you know, there's unique bosses and stuff, you have to, like, you know, take a picture. And if you don't, you fail.
Accept this final challenge.
And no, I lied about fighting Gohdan. We don't ever fight Gohdan, we're fighting Andross. This is Andross from Star Fox. No, but it actually is Gohdan, but the reason I say Andross is because it's the disembodied hands and heads. Head, not heads. Anyway, what you want to do for this boss, you want to start out to shoot the eyes of the hands. This whole boss is about shooting eyes. After you shoot the eyes of the hands, his eyes will open, and yeah, this is where it gets real. And actually, he's gonna shoot a bunch of fireballs at you, but you can just roll out of the way of them, and then shoot the eyes, and keep shooting them, and then you wanna pull out a bomb, and when you pull out a bomb, it'll, like, explode in his mouth. Yeah, he didn't like that snack very much. Oh, crap, I almost forgot. Let's take a picture real quick. Yeah, it's good. Alright. Hang on, I'll be right back. Now, basically, the hands of the eyes are gonna open back up, so you just shoot the hands again to get his actual eyes to open up. Yeah. So, this boss is very easy. I wouldn't consider it the easiest boss, because the easiest boss is, Kaladimus from the Forest Haven, I forgot the actual name of the forest on here, but you know what I'm talking about. Because you can just use some spring water on him. This one actually, I don't think there's an actual good way to, like, get him. I think it's just, like, shooting him with a book. Now you're like, Elien, you're just about out of arrows. What are you gonna do? Well, yeah, he gives you some arrows. And it's pretty cool, so. And just another reason why I think this is one of the easiest bosses. Okay, getting around to do that. But yeah, it's all good. Anyway, his eyes open up for the last time because it's an Nintendo game, and Nintendo's 3 times a charm for every boss slash enemy slash thing. You're not green in here. I seem to always get hit at least once. Boss fights. Now, if you get hit in there, you're bound to get at least 2 hits because that makes you, what's it called? It makes you go in there, and there's no way to really get out of there without, you know, being electrified. Because there's just not. And I'm out of arrows again. Wow. And he's gonna keep doing his stupid moves. Closing his eye, and I got hit again. I just embraced it. Come on, seriously. Stop, jeez. It's getting annoying. Oh my god, stop closing your eyes! And I just jumped in there, oh my god! Dang, I suck. Stop closing your eyes. Come on. And here we go. This will be the last time. And yeah, that does it. And he was totally in the center of the room.
Well, now come to pass this time to your fate, to the path that you've chosen. Go forward with caution.
Yes, we will. Don't worry. The end boss music plays right here, and it gives you a freaking portal. How cool is that? And he goes back in his sleeping area. And he gives you a piece, not a piece of fire, a heart container, and I really don't want that. It probably has boogers on it. Anyway, let's just get it. That starts our second row of heart containers. Yeah, we have 11 now. 11 out of 20. So yeah, let's go ahead and go through. Yay. I think this temple is one of the easier ones. I'd say the Forest Haven, the Forbidden Woods, that was the easiest temple. Because I got it in one video in my wanted time limit, which is 20 to 30 minutes, but last video was 40 minutes. And, we have to get our grappling hook out, so let's put that on R. And here we go. Let's go. And ring the bell. Yeah, the bell has rang, and the path will be open. And that makes a new pathway. You've done well, Elien. It would seem the gods have acknowledged you to be a true hero. This does not mean your trials have ended here. Once you take your first step into the world beyond the ring of light you see shimmering in the waves before you, your true trial will begin. Are you ready, Elien? Yes, we are! Wait, what are we doing? No, I'm not ready for that. No, I'm not ready for this. No, I don't have underwater breathing powers. I'm not a fish. Oh, crap. Dude, it's kind of hard to breathe down here. Dude. Oh, it's perfectly fine. I'm gonna shut up here for the cool music that's about to play. How great is that music? I think it's great. Anyway, yes, this is Hyrule Castle, a very familiar place to Zelda fans. When I first played this game, I thought it was gonna, I didn't think it was gonna ever come. I was wondering why it was called a Zelda game. You're probably wondering where we are, aren't you? Unfortunately, there's not enough time for me to explain it to you now. Once you are able to strike down Ganon with the item you obtained in this castle, all will be made clear to you. Trust in my words. See what awaits you in the castle. Alright. Sounds cool. Kind of. Yeah. That light right there looks so beautiful. So amazing. Alright, enough dilly-dallying. Let's go ahead and head inside. And it looks like we've been frozen in time. At least they've been frozen in time. It looks like Hyrule Castle was attacked. And then you can hear this corrupted music in the background, which eventually does get better, but you'll see what it does. Alright, Elien, I need you to listen to me for a moment. The item you're seeking is hidden somewhere in this castle. To find it, you must find the entrance to the basement. But that entrance has been blocked by a mighty threshold, firmly sealed to prevent evil from ever gaining access. Do you know where to search and what you must do to open the hidden way? You will find a clue in the shape of a heraldry near where we arrived at the castle. What's a heraldry? I mean, I don't know what a heraldry is, guys. That's not what I meant to do. I meant to pull it twice. Well, now we're gonna have to do it a different way, because I'm just an idiot. Anyway. Yeah, this puzzle is just making a triforce with the freaking... the triangular pieces you find in here. But it's all fun. And let's pull this one over here, because... yeah. There's not much to say about this puzzle. There's not really a specific way to do it. I know, but... there's not really a specific way to do this, but... oh no, we're trapped in here forever! Not really. It all comes down. But it makes the Triforce. The one and only. Not really in Link Between Worlds, but you know. That's another game for another time. Maybe if I do it. I don't know if I will. I might. It looks like a path has been opened. Haha, you can't hit me. Oh my god. We should take a selfie here. Hashtag risks. Right there. Link's facial expression. Oh my god. Yeah, I'm saving that. That's going on Miiverse. And let's head down. Let's go down. Yeah. What do you think is going to be in here? Well, that looks familiar to Zelda fans like me. Let's go down these stairs. And we're going to have to take another selfie. Excellent, Elien. To perceive such a puzzle and decipher it, it is no small feat. That puzzle was cake. Now take the sword that lies before you. It is none other than the Master Sword, the Blade of Evil's Bane. It is the only sword that can banish Ganon from the world above. Alright, but first, before we draw it, gotta take a selfie. Hashtag promotion. And he blinked. Wow, no, we gotta do it without blinking. Hashtag promotion. Alright, save it. Alright, now, let's go up. Both of those will be going on the Miiverse, by the way. Let's go draw the Master Sword. Here we go. Oh crap. And? Everyone's putting their swords down, I don't know. Swords down, Toon Link is the best Link. And, by drawing the Master Sword, color has returned to the world. Well, we're about to see that. Color has been returned to the world, and time has been restored. Well, we're about to see that too. But, color has returned so far. Let's see what else happens. And... time has returned. Yes. Now, we're gonna have to get out of here, but getting out of here will be no small feat. We're gonna have to take all of them down. What? Yeah. We got the freaking Master Sword! The Blade of Evil's Bane! Yes! We are the hero of winds. Well, yeah, that was kind of a spoiler right there. I'm sorry about that. You got the Master Sword, legendary blade with the power to repel evil, once wielded by the legendary hero himself. Yeah, you bet we did. I love how big it looks on him. On Adult Link and Ocarina of Time, it looks so small, but on this one, oh my god, it looks gigantic. And the spin attack has more of a bluish color to it, you know? Like, but the Hero Sword spin attack had more of a greenish look to it, to be honest. But, before we leave, very subtle reference right here. Stained glasses of the sages from Ocarina of Time. Man, we're just referencing Ocarina of Time all day in this episode. No, this is Nibiru, a sage that comes from Ganondorf's background, which is kind of crazy if you think about it. Then we have Impa, which was the babysitter that taught us Zelda's lullaby in Ocarina of Time, Zelda's babysitter. Darwinia, which was the chieftain of the Gorons. Then we have Saria, which was Link's best friend when he was a kid, because he was known as a Kokiri, but he soon figured out that he was a Hylian. Then you have Raru, also known as Kiabora, Giabora, Kibora, Gabora, which is that annoying owl that would always like ask you if you would wanted to hear something again. But then the yes and no would be switched to where no is on the bottom, so you would jam the A button because he has nothing useful to tell. And then you would press yes, so yeah. You gotta be careful. Then we have Princess Ruto, which Link kinda lied to her at the game and said that he would marry her, but that was a lie. Yeah, that was pretty bad. You don't just go up to a girl and say it, but you know, you don't lie about something like that. But, yeah, here we go. About to fight a bunch of enemies, so yeah. I'm gonna have to talk a lot louder too because the enemy music is so horribly loud. And the Hero of Time statue has been destroyed. But yeah, we're gonna have to fight all of these now. Orca wants you to give him some night rest, but guess what? You only need 10, and guess what? We have 3 as of now, and you know how many? There is exactly 7 Dark Knights in this place. So guess what? That means we can get 10 instantly, so yeah, we're basically good. Anyways, I think I'm gonna take a Dark Knight sword. As soon as I get these cluster of enemies out of the way. Because, yeah, this is kind of horrible. There's a lot. I don't know how many moblins are in here, but we might want to take some skull necklaces. If we can. Yeah, we can. Alright, cool. Well, we killed one, I heard it. But, let's try to get this other one. Yeah, alright. Sorry about all the voice cracks. My throat kind of hurts, so yeah, that's probably why. Anyways, let's grab your skull necklace and let's just instantly kill you. Not really. You can't instantly kill anyone. Unless it's like a choo-choo, which those are easy. But... wow, that did so much. Let's parry attack this guy. And right there. Well, I somehow didn't get this helmet off by doing that. Let's take a sword. Oh, come on. Come on! Wait, what the heck? How did you get up there? How did he get up there, though? Alright, this might go up there. Alright. That's what I'm worried about. Because that happened on one of my playthroughs. I only got 9 because one of the Dark Knights things, the Knight's Crest, yeah, they went up there where I couldn't get them. And I was an idiot and didn't use the boomerang. Because the boomerang could do that. Alright, let's get this Dark Knight. And parry attack him. Split attack him, if I can, which I can't. Let's take his sword. Or not. Here. Let this be a fair duel. Hey. Oh man. Well, we got the Master Sword, so now it's okay to do. Oh, Jesus. Well, that killed him. Let's get his Knight's Crest. Yeah. My way of telling how many dark guns I killed is basically looking at my inventory. Alright, let's parry attack this guy. Yeah. And take down the rest of his armor. Yes, good job. And right now, I'm pretty sure the dark guns are a little more powerful than Link, even though he has the Blade of Evil's Bane. But the sword, as you can see, it does look a little dull. Well, not really. You can't really tell. But, as you can see, the hilt is not really there. It's closed, and the yellow gem is darkened. We will have to fulfill that later. But, that's actually in the near future. But, not too near. Kind of near. I don't know. Anyway, let's throw the sword right at him. And jump attack him and spin attack him too. That was cool. Like, I did that instantly, simultaneously. Basically, I don't know. I don't know. That was kind of like bad use of words there. Here, let's see if we can sneak up on this guy and like throw this at him and then get his armor to get. Of course. He can. Let's just parry attack him as usual. Take his helmet off and the rest of his armor. Good job. And let's just grab his dark, not his knight's crest, like that, right there. Oh! And that should do it. Now I like something. If there's no weapon nearby a dark knight, and they can't get another weapon while the weapon's out of hand, they can start using martial arts, and I like that detail, because that just shows that they've been trained for a long time, which is really great. I think that's cool, but somehow we still overcome them. We've only been trained for, how many days has this LP been going on? Well, let's just go in parts. We've been trained for 17 parts. So, yeah. I don't know. I hear another Dark Knight. It's probably upstairs. It probably is kind of annoying, me rolling around all the time. What the? Well, these stairs need to be repaired, but let's just draw the sword now. Jesus, I'm stupid. Yeah. I just spit his head feet. Whoa! These guys are strong when they come to punches and crap. They're punches, so. No, not you. I want yours. Or not, because he died, but. Kill me. Oh, he's actually gonna drop one, though, because he has one of those aura balls. I'm just gonna call them aura balls, because that seems like a proper name for them. I like how the Dark Knights can pick up these spears, too. They can basically pick up anything, which is, again, really cool. I'm using the word cool a lot in this episode. I don't know why. A lot of things are cool. Whoa. Okay, just take him out for me, thanks. Whoa! What was that? That was... Oh, crap. Where'd the Dark Knight go? Oh, thank God. His sword's up there. Oh, my God. What the? Taking a picture of that. Hashtag hacks. All right, enough. Let's grab the dark nut, the knight's crest. How many do we have right now? Let's see. We have 10, so yeah, that's enough. How did that happen, though? Well, Hyrule is now even more corrupted because of me, but, you know, I really don't care. Oh, boy. I'm stupid. Alright, so let's just bring this dark Nut Sword. I don't even know what the official name for it is. I'm just calling everything Dark Nut Sword. Dark Nuts Bracelet. I don't know. Where's the last dude? I think he's down here. Yes, he is. Man, wouldn't that just be great? You're just guarding the castle like you're told by Ganon, and then there's some little kid jumps out and throws a freaking giant sword at you. Like, that'd be great. Anyway, the electric force field goes away on both sides, and now let's go forward to Hyrule. And yeah, prepare for some more corruption. And here we go. Yes. Now this looks a lot like Twilight Princess, the back side of Hyrule and Twilight Princess. And of course they couldn't put much detail because this is a toon-y game and they made everything look toon-y. And Twilight Princess is definitely not a toon-y game, but I can't wait. I can't wait to go explore Hyrule. What? Oh. What the heck is this? No! No, I have the Master Sword! Oh. Man. Well, as you can see, if we go back a little further, you can see there's a giant force field around the castle. We will have to deal with that later, but now is not the time. Let's go ahead and head out. Well, not head out. Let's head in, then we'll head out. Alright. Yeah. I will turn in my photos off screen. I don't feel like I need to show you that I'm turning them in because there's really no point. But yeah, let's go ahead and get back in the King of Red Lions. Well, not yet, but now we will. And let's go back up the stream. Are we still underwater? I can't really tell anymore. Anyway, let's go ahead and head back up. And we come out. Now, make sure you get everything there that you need, because, yeah. Not that there really is anything there that you need. There's no pieces of heart or anything. But, and you will be coming back later anyways. But, now that we're hearing the great theme, the great sea theme again, I will see you guys in the next video. Actually, as soon as we get some bait out, because that's the bait fish. And, yeah, we want the Tower of the Gods on the top. Yeah, let's throw some bait up for him. But yeah, this has been Elien. I will see you guys in the next video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, see you guys next time. Bye-bye.